About 2 years ago, I have made a video regarding how to use one Cat5e Ethernet cable to carry two PoE IP camera. Someone said it worked, the other said it don't work. In this video, I'm going to discuss why it doesn't work. First, let's recap what we have done in the last video. I use this cable splitter and connect the cable both end to the splitter. So eventually you can see we've got two network ports both ends, and we use one port for one camera. Totally we've got two PoE IP cameras. There are two kinds of PoE implement. The first implement is the PoE switch or PoE injector use send twist pair to send the power and data. You only need half of twist pair. So it leaves us another half twist pair which unused. Then I use this cable splitter to regroup. So we got second port for the another PoE IP camera. The second PoE implement is the PoE switch or PoE injector. They need different twist pair to send power and data. So if you just use this cable splitter to regroup, separate this power and data twist pair, then it will not work for two cameras. That's the reason why it doesn't work. Now I'm going to use new method to connect two cameras. This is the PoE standard. You can consider the PoE standard just like the PoE switch, one input and two output. But there's difference between the PoE standard and the PoE switch. I will talk about this later. And okay, now let's move to the demonstration wall and see how we can set up the system. I also will tell you what you need to pay attention while you use the PoE standard to work with two cameras. Here we got the PoE switch. This is the network video recorder. The network video recorder is connecting to the PoE switch. This is the cable from the edge. We'll use this cable to carry two cameras. Let's pick one of the PoE port and connect the cable to the PoE switch. Okay, let's move to the PoE standard. We got one input, two output. Okay, let's connect the cable from the PoE switch to the input port of the PoE standard. Let's just wait for a while. You can see the indicator is on, which means the PoE standard is working with the PoE switch now. It's getting the power. All right, I need to use this short patch code to link one of the port to first camera. Okay, let's pick this Y camera first. Okay, now indicator is also on, which means the PoE standard is providing the power and also data exchange with the first camera. Okay, let's got second short patch code to connect another port to the second camera. Now you can see the both indicators on also start flashing, which means now the two camera is getting the data, also power with the PoE switch. We can see both cameras live now. Yes, camera's live. This is the large camera, it's the pan-zoom camera. You need to zoom in and zoom out to find the best focus. So it will take a while before we can see the clear image on the monitor. And remember, we'll talk about the difference between the PoE standard and the PoE switch. Actually, it's not really the switch. You can consider it's the hub, because in the standard PoE switch, there's a addressing table. Before the data packet forward to the next port, you need to look for the addressing table. But the PoE standard doesn't have any addressing table. Once it receives the data packet from these cameras, it will pass to the input and send to the PoE switch immediately. So the latency will be more lower than the PoE switch. And there are several things we need to pay attention by using this PoE standard to repeat the PoE network. The first thing is about power budget. You see, we are using single cable to carry two PoE IP cameras, right? So these two are the very small, the camera requires very small power budget. So it will still fine if we're using the PoE Plus, which can output 30 watts. However, if we are using the high power PoE camera, like the pan-zoom camera, if we just use the 80, which only can output 30 watts, it may not enough to supply the power for two cameras. In that case, we can use the high power PoE injector or 90 watt PoE switch to supply the power for the PoE extender. So you could have enough power for two cameras. The second thing is about cable quality. You see, you're also using the one cable to carry two cameras. If you are using a low cable quality Cat5e or Cat6, it may cause serious power loss. Also, the data, the speed also may be dropped down. So make sure you are using a copper cable. And Cat5e, Cat6, Cat6 always better than Cat5e. And the last thing is about environment. If we are using this PoE standard for outdoor, just make sure you use this grant tool to fasten the grant. So make sure you can keep the water out of the PoE standard. After you fasten the grant above end, the PoE standard can achieve IP67 waterproof weight. You can even bury this PoE standard under the ground. Alright, there's still one more thing. It's about the distance. And with the first method, actually the maximum distance between the cameras and the PoE switch or PoE injector is limited to about 328 feet. But by using this PoE standard, you can totally have about 650 feet. The first distance between the PoE standard and the PoE switch, we can have 328 feet. Then we can have another 328 feet from the PoE standard to your IP cameras. So totally, we not only increase the R345 network port, we also increase the distance between the edge device and the PoE switch. Alright, if you want to connect more than two cameras, you can reference my another video, how to use the outdoor PoE standard to connect up to 7 IP cameras.